Would you feel safe bicycling on this road? Would you feel comfortable on this one? Do you think everyone would feel comfortable? What about kids? Would you even attempt to ride on this one? Clearly not everyone would agree about their level of comfort on these different roads. Some people may use the bike lane in the first video enthusiastically, while others might not feel comfortable riding there.
These differences in feelings of safety and comfort pose a challenge to transportation engineers and policymakers who would prefer to have an objective measure of the roadway environment. They want to know how much more popular an off-street path would be compared to a bike lane, for example. Objective measures make it easier to prioritize bike projects, assess safety, and measure system effectiveness. Because these kinds of comparisons are so valuable, state and local agencies have taken on the difficult task of developing performance measures for bicycle facilities. What are performance measures and how do we create them?
Bicycle performance measures are sort of a rating scale for bicycle facilities that consider a range of attributes, including safety, comfort, and facility quality. To estimate the performance, agencies need to collect, analyze, and report information regarding various elements of the infrastructure. There are currently two performance measures that are commonly used by state and local agencies. The first is called bicycle level of service. This performance measure uses objective data about the bicycle infrastructure and compares it to the subjective experiences of cyclists. Agencies who use this performance measure collect all kinds of data, including lane width, proportion of on-street parking occupied, vehicle volume, and pavement condition. When agencies use this performance measure, the results are applied to road segments as letter grades. Here's an example of a roadway that received an A rating, and here's one that received a lower C rating. The second commonly used performance measure is called level of traffic stress. Level of traffic stress is popular with cities because it's easy to use and understand. Level of traffic stress doesn't need as much information about the road to use, and it doesn't require calculations to apply. Level of traffic stress is based in part on a system that groups cyclists by experience and comfort. The four classifications are nervous riders and kids, interested but concerned, enthused and confident, and strong and fearless. A road rated 4 would be suitable only for the strongest riders, while a road rated 1 would be good for cyclists with children.
Bicycle level of service and level of traffic stress take very different approaches to measuring bicycle facility performance. How do they compare to each other? And how do they compare to the perceptions of cyclists when they use those facilities?
A team of researchers at UC Berkeley's SafeTREC wanted to know the answers to these questions. To do this, the study uses a survey that asks participants to respond to videos of bicycle traveling on a wide variety of road segments in the San Francisco Bay Area. The same clips I've been showing you in this video already. Survey participants watched the clips and gave their opinions about how safe and comfortable they would feel riding on those segments. They compared the survey ratings to the performance measure ratings of the road segments shown in the videos. So what did the researchers find? Let's take a look at some of the clips and find out. Here's an example where all performance measures agree. This is a road with a wide, buffered bike lane and only one lane of traffic to the left. You can see the scores on the right-hand side of the screen. The first number is the bicycle level of service score. A is the best for cyclists, while F is the worst. Level of traffic stress scores go from 1, comfortable for nervous riders and riders with kids, to 4, for the strong and fearless only. The survey ratings range from 1 to 5. An average of 1 means that all of the survey respondents feel very comfortable riding on this segment. An average of 5 means everyone is really uncomfortable. For this segment, survey respondents appreciated the wide bike lane and good pavement condition. Here's one where all three measures agreed again. In this case, they all agree that this is not a good facility for cyclists. There are fast-moving cars, parked cars, and no bike lane. Survey respondents gave this segment the lowest rating. One survey respondent cited the fast-moving traffic and lack of bike lanes as a reason to be uncomfortable here. There are also many instances where there is disagreement between the performance measures. Here's one example. The bicycle level of service on this one is high, while the level of traffic stress is a 4. Survey respondents put this one somewhere in the middle. The bicycle level of service rating is high due to the shoulder width, but level of traffic stress gives it a low rating due to the high traffic speeds. Survey respondents noted the fast-moving traffic as a negative as well. One respondent thought a protected bike lane would be needed here for them to feel comfortable. Here's another disagreement. Survey respondents found this to be an okay segment, but level of traffic stress rated this highly. Bicycle level of service gave this a lower rating due to the pavement condition. It's not as good as it could be. So what kind of broader conclusions can we draw from this analysis? The study found that there are some issues with both performance measures when compared to the survey results. The bicycle level of service measure had only a weak correlation with the survey results. 10 road segments were classified as D, but among them included the segment survey respondents felt the most comfortable with. Level of traffic stress tended to rate segments at the extremes, either 1 or 4. Some of the segments rated 4 survey respondents were generally comfortable with. This is because traffic speed is a key factor for level of traffic stress. All segments rated 4 had streets with fast-moving traffic. Survey respondents didn't seem to mind high traffic speeds if there was good bicycle facilities, but level of traffic stress didn't pick up on that nuance.
Here are some of the big takeaways from this survey. Cyclists cared about the quality of bicycle facilities and really liked wide bicycle lanes. Survey respondents rated those segments highly. Respondents also cared about separation from traffic, especially fast-moving traffic. Neither performance measure adequately captured the benefits survey respondents gained from protected or buffered bike lanes. There's still a long way to go before these performance measures can adequately capture all the nuances of cyclist safety and comfort and bicycle facilities.
Check out the paper linked in the description below to get more detail about the topics covered in this video. This paper also uses the survey data to develop a framework for a new performance measure to help agencies evaluate bicycle facilities and understand how improvements can affect different types of cyclists.